Hello everyone, SunTendo2, welcome to another mod overview, this time on Banana Decor. A mod that simply adds in colored lamps, a bush, different forms of stone, so you've got marble, you've got tan, you've got a few others. You've got walls, stairs, slabs, pillars, and quicksand. So, we'll just take a look at a few of these. They do all have recipes, as well as a few other elements to them, and I'll see what I can find with World Gen regarding the new stones, such as the dark, tanned, and marble. So, take a look at those. It's just polished inside. So, first up we have the bush, which is just simply something you'll find in the world, I'd guess. I don't know if this actually grows to be a much bigger. Nope, so it is just a small bush, as you can see there. So there's that for decoration. Unless I need to expand the growth ticks, which I might actually do just in case, as not everything works with burning. Random tick speed, increase it by a lot, and something would usually grow by about that point, so it doesn't change with that either. We have the lamps, which obviously are now coloured or dyed, and you just use 8 dye around a redstone lamp. So there's that. This is what they look like illuminated. I think I'm missing one. Obviously the redstone not reaching that far. So we'll just get a block here. Don't need the bush anymore. Will illuminate the side. So that's what all of them looks like. There is the light grey and the grey here. They are kind of hard to tell when they aren't lit up, but even when they are lit, you can see a bit of a difference. But the rest are a lot more clear what colour they are. From white there to black, and so on. And blue. But yeah, that's what those look like. And the recipes for the rest are probably self-explanatory, we're just swapping out dyes. So there's that. Next we have dark stone, which you can find in the world, probably similar to granite, andesite, and diorite. And you can make these into bricks, walls, slabs, and stairs of irregular kind. And then if you use the bricks, you can obviously smelt it into cracked, if you wish, where you can make the following out of those as well. You can make a pillar simply if you have the required material and a gravity shifter. So all pillars require that to add display elements, which we'll cover soon. And you've also got things like the mossy variation and a pillar without a display element as well. These are also chiseled slabs. And then the rest of these obviously have their own, but I think marble sort of expands in its own way. There's also black marble, apparently, which I didn't realise. Then you've also got the polished and otherwise of the andesite, diorite, and granite. And then you've got walls and cobble versions and other such stuff like that, as you can see there. We'll move on to the pillars though, as they do have unique elements to them. So the regular ones don't have anything going on, but eventually once we click over to some others, you'll see that we have a slot here that we can put stuff in. So for example, we want to put our prize lapis block, for example, on here. You can look at it and it'll place some text above the actual object you've got there, or the item. So if we want, say, a jack-o'-lantern to be in here, we can. We won't illuminate, though. But if we want specific items, then we can. Let's put, say, a pickaxe in here, for example. We'll put a sort of regular as well. I guess a lantern, a torch, or a few other things. Obviously just any display element you want to put here, you can, no problem. There's that. But again, obviously you need the gravity shifter. among any of the other resources, and in that slot there, the typical pillars obviously don't have that. Finally though, we have quicksand, which again you can find in the world, and if you just happen to end up in some, you have the particles around you showing that you're sinking into it, as well as the animation of course, and I'm at the bottom. So, yeah. I assume you can possibly suffocate in this as well, but we'll get some sand here, and I don't think it, nope, doesn't have gravity. So just jump in here, and we'll see what happens. So we just walk in, yeah, we do suffocate, but it's an easy way to also hide, I guess, from other players, possibly. As well, either way. But yeah, this is intended to be dangerous. But we'll just take a look around and see how it generates. So let's see, we've got some marble here. And I assume some black marble. Let's see, what else can we find? Mostly marble it seems currently. I don't see any stone. Here we go. There's some more marble. It might be biome dependent then, for all I know. So, let's see. We'll have to take a look around. It's more marble. It's also more marble. Okay, so we'll... Actually, we'll look underneath, as I assume they're not obviously all above ground. But we'll see what chance we have for things. So we've got... more marble, we have some tanned. Just need to be kind of creative for this. So we can see with a light source. Should get some night vision actually. So make it easier to tell. Get the extended version. So you've got some tanned stone here. Got marble again. And we've got our dark stone. And I think there was one more, if I can find that. Seems I can't. Let's see, banana. And let's see, unless that was everything. I can't quite remember though. Let's see, what is the detail? Make it clear here, so the decor, we've got darkstone, tanned, marble. That was it, okay. I thought there was a second one for some reason. The fourth one or so, I should say. Fifth, actually. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Obviously in similar vein sizes as the other stones, and should be accessible to find either above or below ground. Thanks so much for watching, though, and goodbye.